whole pose technique is a fundamental exercise in Tai Chi. Essentially, you're standing. It's also known as standing practice. Hands and shoulders and elbows want to be relaxed. They're in the same sort of position as the ward-off movement at the start of the grass bird tail. Big circle. Position is comprised of circles. Circle here, circle behind the legs as if you're sitting on a large ball. Little circle, you could fit an egg under the armpit. Sometimes they hold with the hands as well, a little circle. Externally rotate the thigh bones. You'll feel like there's a circle in between the legs as well. And that will lift the arches of the feet. So you get little circles under the arches of the feet as well. It moves your body weight a little to the outside edges of the feet, which is good. The pelvis is generally gently tucked. So there's a sense of a circularity there as well. What you're actually doing is just elongating the lower back. Likewise, you try to elongate the upper back into the neck. So sometimes people will say tuck the chin. If you just tuck the chin, you can get kind of jammed in the neck. So instead, what you want to do is you imagine you're lifting the crown of the head, lengthening the spine, lengthening the spine. And it's a great exercise for learning the right kind of feeling in the body for Tai Chi. If we were doing old school, you know, hold for about half an hour or something, my old teacher used to get us practicing for 36 breaths. Now when he did that, that was about 36 minutes. Because he breathed very slowly. If you force the breath too slowly, you'll compensate. You'll breathe very fast on the next breath. So it's important just to sink and relax the breath. The mind technique, the first level of the mind techniques, is just to relax the breath, relax the mind, focus on the lower stomach. Try to sink the breath down as deep as you can. It's really good if you can, I don't know, be somewhere private or not worry about looking fat, because that'll help you relax the breath into the lower stomach. And then you count the breaths. Just gently, tip of the tongue, touching the roof of the mouth, breathing through the nose, sinking the breath into the lower stomach 36 times. If you're a beginner, that may be 4 or 5 minutes. When I practice, I don't count anymore. I'll just practice 10 or 15 minutes. And try to be aware of the sensations in your body. There's a lot to think about in the posture I just described. So you can give yourself a cue. You can cue yourself from the head down and be like, tuck the chin or extend the crown of the head, relax the shoulders, lift the back, relax the elbows and wrists. Relax the spine, gentle tuck, externally rotate the thigh bones. That one's important if you get any knee pain. If you just bend the knees and come forward, you can get pressure on the knees. So you want to sink down, little tuck, external rotation, so you're holding the body's weight in the buttocks as well as the thighs. And that can keep pressure out of the knees. Check in with the knees, ankles, feet, and relax. On the last exhalation, you can press the hands down, straighten the legs, and step the feet back together. You can also bring the hands down to the lower stomach.